is level one, lesson two, in our segment of Larry Lessons. We've covered games one through five, the friendly game, the porcupine game, the driving game, moving away from rhythmic pressure, the yo-yo game, the circling game with transitions, and today we're going to start with the circle game. We'll review it, and we're going to do a change of direction in the circle game, and then we'll progress to sideways game and squeeze game. So for circle game, I'm going to back up Cesari out of my space, get wherever it is that I want to be, maybe out here, free of some of these obstacles, and then I'm going to get him to face me and back up again about 6 feet out of my space. Now he's set up to go to his right, my left, so I'm going to, now it doesn't matter, he just changed his feet. But I will go to my, now he's set up to go to the right, so we'll go to the right. We have horses passing us, so I've lost his attention. So I can get his attention by just going and becoming more important in those horses, or I would have to do something totally different. So this will work. I have his attention just by starting. So he wants to walk, which is fine. The change of direction will be initiated when he's behind my back. Again, my coming out of neutral to talk to him when he's behind my back is, would you please, blah, 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 whatever I want. It's a polite way to prepare him for a transition. Instead of just startling him when he's in front of me, it would be more like a command. So when he goes behind my back, I'm going to turn my body towards his hindquarters, and then I'm going to put my stick under the rope, bring him in towards me. Now he did that very well and fast, so I have to kind of stop it and back him out of my space, and then I'm just going to do a reset the other direction. So my little dance step is going to be turn towards the hindquarters, two step backwards, two steps forward to help him find a new direction. Okay, so he's circling, but he's too close to me. So I'm going to put pressure on zone three and drive him out. Get his circle bigger. I also don't want him going behind my back when he's so close to me. This is better. We're going to do a change of direction at the trot. It's going to happen fast. Here we go. Back up. He didn't look at me, so I played a yo-yo game and sent him off. Get him out of my space. So he's very distracted and playful right now, kind of going between both emotions. We'll try this again. Turn towards the hindquarters, step back two. He didn't follow me, so I had to yo-yo, push him out of my space, send him in his new direction. And I'll do one more at a trot. Then we'll ask it a walk. Hopefully, he'll see me coming out of neutral and be prepared for this, which he hasn't been. So here we go. Coming out of neutral. Cesari, would you please change direction? So again, he's not really focused on me. So we're going to see if we can make a change with that. I'm going to start doing some transitions. So I'm going to turn towards his travel of motion with a driving game and ask for a walk. Okay, no, I would like you to walk, not stop. Walk is what I wanted, not a trot. Walk, I need a walk. And then when my body goes to neutral, it says thank you. So here we go with a walk. you're supposed to be walking. Thank you. Every time my body goes to neutral, it says thank you. Now I'm going to ask for a trot by turning towards the hindquarters and letting my energy from my belly button hit him in his hindquarters and lifting my lead hand. So here we have a nice little trot. And now I'm going to ask for a walk when he goes behind me. So I'm going to turn towards him with a driving game. Thank you. But I need a walk. I need a walk on a circle. Good. Now I'm going to try a change of direction. So he's behind, going behind me. I'm going to turn, step back, step forward, and put him back out on the circle. That was super. Much, much better. Now his head's lowering, so that tells me he's starting to focus on me a little bit more and relax. He's been a little bit upset because those horses left the property. So I'm going to do a walk transition. I'm going to start adding the rope because he's blowing through the stick. He's asking a question. Can I stop? And I said, no, let's pick up. Keep on a walk. Ooh, you're supposed to be walking. Not stopping, walking to my right. Not trotting, not stopping. So here we have our walk. This is very nice. I'm going to ask for a trot. You're supposed to be walking. So here comes the trot. I'm turning. Very nice. Phase one. Neutral says thank you. Ask for the walk. Nice. But let's keep walking. Good boy. Whoop, you're supposed to be walking. You're supposed to be walking. To my right. Supposed to be walking. To my right. Good boy. Neutral means good boy. So we'll do a change of direction, turn towards the hindquarters, step back, step forward, and push him out onto the new circle. And I don't care that he breaks gait on a change of direction. One day in level two, if we do a change of direction from a walk, I'll expect a walk to for the whole movement, or if he's trotting, I'll expect a trot for the whole movement, but right now, I don't care. I'm just looking for the change of direction. Now, this time, when he goes behind my back, I'm going to stop it, stop the game by running my hand down the rope and talking to those hindquarters. Thank you. Good boy. Good boy. So that was a great demo because we had a lot of problem solving. Cesare was very distracted with horses leaving and he wasn't totally focused on me, so lots of different things showed up, which makes it more interesting. It's an oh boy situation. I get to have some fun and variety and fix this. So that was super. Thank you so much for your attention and your respect. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Till next time, adios.